connect your Robo E4 to RoboCloud, the first thing you need to do is make sure your printer is online. So check the top toolbar for either an Ethernet or Wi-Fi symbol. Once you're online, click on the gear icon on the left-hand side to enter the Tools menu. From there, look for the icon in the top that looks like a cloud. From your cloud menu, you have a few different options, including RoboCloud and My STEM Kits. Click on RoboCloud to open that menu and toggle it on. When you do so, a registration code will be generated. You will use this registration code on the RoboCloud website to connect your printer to your account. On your computer, go to cloud.robo3d.com and either log into or register for an account. Click on My Printers to go to your printer management page, and then add printer. At this point, you are asked to give your 3D printer a name and enter the registration code. Then click OK to add your printer to your account. Your printer will then appear in your available printers. Now notice it will come in as offline, but give it a minute or two before it will switch to idle, which is available to print on. To send your first print, go into My Model and either upload or select a model of your choosing. To upload a model, click where it says upload model and then choose model files. Be aware, RoboCloud can only accept STL files. Once you've selected up to 8 STLs, click upload. As each one uploads, it will disappear from the list. Close the window when all of your files are uploaded. Once you've uploaded a model you'd like to print, simply select the model from your My Models library. This will open up a preview of it, where you can actually zoom around and look at your model from different angles. You can also download it if you need to access that file on your computer again. Click Print to go into the printer slicer settings. From this window, you will have the option of selecting a 3D printer. So click from the dropdown and make sure that you have your Robo E4 selected. When you do so, the sample build plate will adjust to fit your specific 3D printer. Now on the right-hand side here, we have a few different options. So you can move, rotate, or scale your object in case you need to make minor adjustments. You can also go into print settings and change some of the defaults. For one, by default, RoboCloud will include both supports and a raft on your model. So if your model doesn't need those, feel free to simply disable those before continuing. You will also find a variety of quality settings, low, standard, or high, and you can further adjust them at the bottom of the menu. Once you're happy with the settings you've selected, click Print to queue the item on your 3D printer queue. This will not actually send it to print yet, but it will add it to the list of items to be printed on this machine. From this window, you can see any items that you have in your print queue and can even move them to the front using the arrow with the line on top of it. From here, your 3D printer should now have switched to idle, and within about 5 seconds, the pause button here should switch to a start button, which will actually start the 3D print running on your machine. Now, if at any point while you're printing, you would like to see a live view of what is going on in your 3D printer, you can actually turn on the camera and view it remotely. To do so, click on the camera icon in the top right corner of your preview area to activate the camera on the machine. The video may take a minute or two to load, but when it does, you will get a live view of what is going on inside your 3D printer, and it'll update every 30 seconds to a minute so you can see what's going on with your print. If you see anything you need to pause or cancel your print remotely, you can do that as well. So there you go. That is how you use your Robo E4 with RoboCloud.